During a fight scene in The Dark Knight Rises, Batman exhorts Catwoman to put away her weapon. No killing, he says. No guns. Sadly, in the Century 16 Theater last night, life did not imitate that bit of art, and the midnight premiere of that film became a killing ground. Tonight, families are reeling, a young man is in custody, and police are trying to figure out how to disarm the suspect's apartment loaded with explosive booby traps.
Copycat crimes are common throughout the media. There have been multiple films and shows that influence the actions of the everyday person.
The hypodermic needle theory is a communication studies model derived from the research of numerous scholars from the 1920s to the 1930s with the commercialization of radio and television and the emergence of advertising propaganda. According to Media and Culture, an Introduction to Mass Communication, written by Richard Campbell, Christopher Martin, and Bettina Fabos, the hypodermic needle theory, also known as the magic bullet theory or the direct effects model, assumes that the media injects direct and powerful effects on unwary and susceptible individuals.
Captivation is a social theory which examines the long-term effects of TV. The more time people spend living in the TV world, the more likely they are to believe social reality portrayed on television. According to Television and Its Viewers, written by James Shanahan and Michael Morgan, cultivation theory was developed by Professor George Gerbner, who is the Dean of the Annenberg School of Communication at University of Pennsylvania. Gerbner began his research in the mid-1960s to see if and how watching TV may influence the viewer's ideas of what our everyday world is like.
On July 20, 2012, a man by the name of James Holmes attended the midnight screening of The Dark Knight Rises at the Century 16 Multiplex Theater in Aurora, Colorado. According to reports provided by CNN, Holmes exited the theater 18 minutes into the film and returned armed with an AR-15 rifle, 12-gauge shotgun, and two .40-caliber handguns, and a full attire of protective gear. Investigators report that Holmes allegedly threw two tear gas canisters before opening fire. The mass shooting resulted in 12 deaths and 58 wounded and is considered one of the worst tragedies to happen in the U.S.
Police observed his hair was dyed orange. He told them, "I am the Joker." He also told them the movie theater, his apartment, and his car were booby-trapped, just like the comic book villain would do.
Dexter surrounds a man named Dexter Morgan, who is a blood splatter analyst and a killer of serial killers. According to WLWT, 17-year-old Andrew Connolly strangled his little brother to death after watching episodes of Dexter. Connolly stated, "I feel just like him."
According to TheGuardian.com, on Monday, September 29th, 2014, prosecutors in the ongoing trial of Kuntal Patel claim that she tried to murder her own mother using Abrin, a poison very similar to ricin, the poison used by Walter White in the critically acclaimed show Breaking Bad. In Spokane, Washington, Jason Hart is currently on the trial for the murder of his girlfriend, following in which it is claimed he tried to dispose of her body in the same way Walter and Jesse did, by dissolving it in acid.
Pick up the phone.
Hello.
Is it done? Is he gone?
Yeah, it's done. He's gone. They're all gone.
Todd? Who is this?
Walt, how are you feeling? Kind of under the weather? Like you've got the flu? That would be the ricin I gave you. I slipped it into that stevia crap that you're always putting in your tea. Oh my God.
Cultivation influences a person's reality. The more an audience watches it, the more they believe it can be reality. The magic bullet theory is when the conveyed message from the TV is injected into the mind. This causes an immediate reaction from the receiver.
In a magic bullet study, we predict that through the magic bullet theory, the ideas and opinions of viewers on certain topics would change after media usage. But in a cultivation study, the long-term usage of media will not make a viewer's opinions change, but instead reinforce their opinions. Both the magic bullet and cultivation theories complement each other as they both rely on the idea that media affects viewers.